आज हमारे साथ आशीष जी हैं और आशीष जी के बारे में मैं बता दूं इंटरव्यू से पहले ही कि वो इज इंजीनियर बाय ट्रेनिंग बट एन एंटरप्रेन्योर एट हार्ट। एक छोटे से शहर से आते हैं, पूना के, वर्धा डिस्ट्रिक्ट के, और लेकिन सपने कभी छोटे नहीं देखे, हमेशा बड़े सपने देखे। और पिछले 20 साल से वो आईएच फैक्ट्री करके एक डिजिटल मार्केटिंग कंपनी चलाते हैं जो बहुत ही सक्सेसफुल कंपनी है। मेरे ख्याल से पूना और महाराष्ट्र की सबसे बड़ी कंपनीज में से है वो डिजिटल मार्केटिंग की। उनका पूना में, बैंगलोर में और यहाँ तक कि ऑस्ट्रेलिया में पूरा उनका क्लाइंट बेस है। तो ऐसे आशीष हमारे साथ आज जुड़े हैं, सो वी आर रियली थैंकफुल टू यू दैट यू कुड टेक आउट द टाइम एंड एफर्ट्स फॉर दिस।
इट्स माय प्रिविलेज रिक्शल।
Great. So let us start by a very simple question. Could you please tell us about your professional journey? How did it all start? So back in your engineering days, did you have anything of this kind in mind? Ki digital marketing mein jana hai? Yeah. How did it all just flow?
So essentially, as you know, that I am from a very small town. I am an engineer. I did my engineering from Nagpur University. And after doing my engineering, then I was clueless basically what is required to be done, because I come from a business background. Way back in 1997, when I passed out, wahan pe do hi type ke option hote the. Either you go and join your family business, else you get into services. It's the kind of an environment, the kind of ecosystem which exists today, didn't used to exist. The entrepreneurship or startup culture itna zyada nahi hua karta tha. So, but I wanted to try out my luck. I wanted to explore myself to the fullest of my potential. So I landed up in a place called Pune, which I am here right now. Then I joined an engineering firm. Because at that time, it was also happening that if a man has done engineering, he will go to the engineering profession. If someone has done architecture, he will get into architecture. If someone has done something in hospitality industry, they will get into hospitality industry. So as my education qualification was from engineering background, the first option was certainly to try out my luck with an engineering background and an engineering industry. But once I landed up over here and then I started working with the organization, over a period of time I realized that by education I might be an engineer, but that is not what my interest, that is not what is my strength as well. And then I started introspecting myself. When I started introspecting myself, then I penned down saying that what is that I'm good with and what is that I'm bad with? What is that I like to do? What is that I not like to do? What is that would make me successful and what is that not going to make me as successful as it could be? And when I started writing down these sets of the skill sets on the thing, then I realized one thing, that there's only one field which I like, which comes down as a part of my career path, which I should be selecting, and that's going to be marketing. And that's how then I started giving interviews at multiple organization, multiple companies, just to try out my luck. And believe me one thing, कि जब आप एक छोटे गांव से आते हो तो बहुत सारे constraints आपके साथ में होते हैं। आपका communication नहीं होता है, आपका exposure इतना अच्छा नहीं होता है, आपका confidence level इतना अच्छा नहीं होता है। So when I started looking out for the job and trying to put up my hands into marketing as a field, there had been a series of interview which I started giving. Okay, so at that point of time, it was probably around 50 odd different interviews which I attended over a period of 2-3 months kind of in duration. And to my surprise, okay, none of the organizations selected me, because they felt like confidence nahi hai bande mein, communication nahi hai, iska knowledge nahi hai, experience nahi hai, exposure nahi hai, body language us tarike ki nahi hai. So everyone rejected me. But I was determined enough that I want to make something into a field of marketing only. Then interview to interview, multiple rounds of interview. And there had been a very much of the low phases which were happening in my career, in my mind. Because as you can understand that if 45, 50 companies don't select you, what kind of a phase you will go through. But determination is a success to your key, because you have to keep doing it again and again, again and again, despite of understanding that you are failing. Finally, I got a job into a company, and the name of that company is IKEA. It's the same company which I own today. It's the same company which I run today. When I joined this particular company, then I started understanding, boss, my keen interest is to be in marketing, but skill set mein utni match nahi kar rahi hai. Okay, जो एक सॉफ्ट स्किल होनी चाहिए मार्केटिंग करने के लिए, कम्युनिकेशन जो होना चाहिए. सो आई स्टार्टेड वर्किंग अ लॉट ऑन माई सेल्फ, एंड ओवर अ पीरियड ऑफ टाइम देन देयर हैव बीन लॉट्स ऑफ अप्स एंड डाउन्स इन द सेम ऑर्गेनाइजेशन ऑल्सो, बिकॉज सेम ऑर्गेनाइजेशन वाज ऑल्सो थिंकिंग ऑफ exiting me, was ready to give me a pink slip to move out of the organization because sales were also not moving to me. Though, जिस तरीके से आज YouTube होता है, Google speed is available, loads of knowledge information is available on internet today. It wasn't there at that point of time. So only way you could succeed at that point of time was to do a lot of learning on your own level. Internet speed भी उस तरीके की नहीं होती थी. But then I used to meet up lots of people, interact with loads of people. I used to join a British library. वहाँ पे जाके sales और marketing के कुछ किताबें पढ़ना चालू किया. And then I started sharpening my skill. And there was one point of time when the management of the company wanted to shut down the company because nothing was happening. So that's the time when the entrepreneurial zeal of mine was at the peak. And then I thought ki I should approach my management saying that let me run the company. I went to them with a lot of due diligences. They offered me a position of to be a marketing head. Despite of not great doing in a sales, but they also had no other option other than appointing me. Otherwise, company ko band karna padta tha. Aur jab ye sab cheeze chalu hui aur jab responsibility aane lag gayi, so there's two things. Okay, one is responsibility and second is authority. They gave me a responsibility, but I was lacking authority. So what I did was I started stealing or sharpening my authority skill. Ki ab agar haath mein kaam le liya to usko khatam karna hai. And then is the time when my fortune started moving in. I was able to recruit a couple of good people. I was able to sharpen my skill. I was able to start closing my business leads. And that's how the journey all started. And eventually at one point of time, I took over the company from the existing management. They also didn't have any problem because they could see that I was moving the organization to a different level. And that's how the entire journey started.
Great.
So I am, to be precise, like accidental entrepreneur. So there wasn't any mindset ki entrepreneurship karna hai, kuch bahut high aspirations hai. But necessity is the mother of all invention. So usi tarike se necessity banti gayi. I started upscaling myself, and that's how I am today an owner of the company.
Great. Like, this is a very, very interesting story. Aur jitna hard work aur struggle aapne kiya hai aur uske baad pura apne pairon pe khade hue hain. So I think this is a very inspirational thing for us. अब अगला आप ये बताइए कि आपकी कंपनीज क्या-क्या अलग-अलग किस्म की सर्विसेज प्रोवाइड करती है।
Okay, so the year 2000 when I joined this particular company, internet was just getting into India. Okay, so the way we see internet connectivity, broadband connectivity, lease line connectivity, every other person having a broadband connection or हर आदमी का वेबसाइट, उस वक्त में वो सब चीजें नहीं हुआ करती थी। उस वक्त में people having email itself was a very fanciest thing because it was replacing the fax machine at that point of time. So as we move forward, as the evolution was happening upon internet space or in a digital space, okay, so what we also did is we moved out from selling domain name to email services to web pages to website to e-commerce and application development kind of thing. So as of now today, we are a full service digital branding and marketing agency. Okay, and under this thing, we offer end-to-end services. As internet, as the digital industry was evolving, we also started evolving. So today we feel very proud and privileged to say that we are among very few companies who offers end-to-end services to our customers. So when we talk about services, it starts from website designing, website maintenance, e-commerce development, social media marketing, search engine optimization, performance marketing, and multiple such kind of things. Then we also do quite a lot of mobile apps because now mobile app is on the train. So we are doing a lot of mobile app project as well.
Okay. So can you please brief us about the current scenario of the industry your business is involved in, especially keeping COVID-19. So how was the market before COVID and how do you see it to be after COVID?
So there is a 360 degree change in the scenario, what it used to be. So before we went down for a lockdown, okay, and now we are in a phase of lockdown being getting released. Okay, so entire situations are changed. The time when I shut down my office because of the lockdown situation, now the time when we are resuming back the offices, nothing which was existing today, nothing which was relevant at that point of time is going to be relevant today. Businesses are facing very different level of the challenges. Okay. And one thing which during this 90 days of the lockdown, which we had evolved, is everyone started understanding digital is the only way to move forward. Because traditional marketing, traditional approaches of doing the businesses, traditional brick and mortar businesses are not going to be sustainable enough. Okay. So during this 90 period of time, Zoom as a platform, Skype as a platform, Google Hangout as a platform has really replaced a physical meetings, physical interactions. Okay, and today people are absolutely good to meet, to interact, to negotiate, to book the orders over the Skype. पहले क्या होता था कि चलो आ जाओ बैठ जाओ चाय पे मिलते हैं बात कर लेते हैं तो देयर वर लॉट ऑफ टाइम्स गैप्स लॉट ऑफ फिजिकल इंटरेक्शंस वर इन्वॉल्वड सो आई थिंक दैट इज नॉट व्हिच इज रिक्वायर्ड एट एनी गिवन पॉइंट ऑफ टाइम नाउ व्हाट्स हैपनिंग इज एज पीपल हैव स्टार्टेड स्टार्टिंग विद देयर बिजनेसेस नाउ व्हाट दे हैव स्टार्टेड इज लॉकडाउन के पहले तो बिजनेसेस फुल फ्लेज्ड चल ही रहे थे ओके ड्यूरिंग लॉकडाउन एवरीथिंग वाज ऑन अ पॉज स्टेज एंड दिस वाज 90 डेज वाज एन इंट्रोस्पेक्शन फेज फॉर एवरी अदर बिजनेसेस Everyone was attending soft skill training or management sessions or marketing sessions and operation sessions or HR sessions and whatnot kind of thing. People started one thing that digital is the only way forward. So if at all an organization is required to grow, will have to be relevant in this particular scenario. So there is only one thing which will make them sustainable is a usage of a digital platform. Okay, so digital, when I talk about, I speak on two different elements. One is a digital technologies and the second one is a digital marketing. So digital marketing, wherein all your customer onboarding, customer engagement, customer acquisition will all have to happen digitally. Okay, so your website, your placement on Google search engine, your social media presence, your paid and performance campaigns are going to play a very, very critical role because salesperson today cannot move to a customer. Okay, even if he wants to move a customer also doesn't want to meet up anyone. Because one thing everyone is really scared about is the COVID situation, okay, social distancing. So with this social distancing, there is a new norm of a social selling, social listening, social influencing, social communication, social selling is going to get adopted. So that is what is a major shift which we are seeing today right now in our industry, which is happening now. Second thing is all the delivery of the services will need to happen through the technologies. Work from home is getting into a new normal now. So when work from home is going to get into a new normal, which means that jo delivery pehle office pe baith ke hua karti thi, now that delivery cannot happen at office because we are also 60 people team. We work with 900 customers. So it's difficult for me also to call up all my teammates into the office and ask them to work. But team is pretty adaptive. 90 days had trained everyone to deliver the product and deliver the services sitting at their own comfort, at their own houses. So today we have our 60 people sitting in 25 different locations and seamless deliveries are happening to customer. So two things which was happening, because of digital marketing, we were continuously bombarded with lots of inquiry flow because everyone was very curious to understand how digital marketing will be able to help them grow their business. Okay, retain their customer. And on the other side, digital technologies is to deliver the customer. Because if you acquire a customer and if you are not able to deliver, then the entire thing goes for the toss. Second thing, you have a great, you have invested a lot into digital technologies, digital infrastructure. But if you don't have a consistent flow of the customers approaching you, then that's again another challenge. So everything will have to go very parallel to each other, digital marketing and the digital technologies. So I think people are very open now. If they are not open, they will have to be very open and adaptive to using a digital technologies and digital marketing.
I think what you said is very important because the industry has to adapt to coming to online modes. And this is also a major concern of our parents, jo hamare students ke parents hai, unko ye lagta hai ki ab aage jaake bacche hamare course kar rahe hain, degree mil jayegi, lekin uske baad jobs kaise hogi. So, I want you to talk about what do you think, work from home or regular office setup, which is more suitable for your industry?
See, essentially, it will have to be a hybrid model. Okay, having all people come and deliver the product and services from office is also not feasible. And just having and work from home also will not be possible because as a India, we lack in terms of lot of infrastructure. So people who are in a very remotest area who have great skill, but they are not in a position to deliver because of the internet connectivity being one of the major challenges. Second thing is the consistent supply of the electricity or a UPS infrastructure or probably work from home major dedication like that, table, chair, or the peace of the mind. So I think it will require to be into hybrid model. So what we have started doing is out of 60 people, we will have probably 15-20 people start working from our offices in the next couple of days. So these are all front-ending customers. these are people who will be directly interacting with the tier, with clients and with the team. So project management is going to be very, very critical role out here, because you will have to be sitting remotely. Client is at remote location, you are at remote location, your team is also at a remote location. So what will be very important and key skill here will be your project management skill. Okay, project management skill, and then use of couple of technology as a platform. So platform like where you can timesheets ho jaye, ya phir ticketing system ho jaye, ya phir workflow management automation system ho jaye. So similar on those kind of in line. So I think this is something which is going to evolve eventually. So another question which you asked me is a relevance of an education which is being provided right now to students. So I guess, yes, there is a 100% reason that parents and students and academics should be really concerned about what is that you're going to teach now. Because skill set which I possessed before lockdown started is no more relevant. Okay, so you will have to become more agile. You'll have to become more fast-paced. You'll have to do multitasking over there. And at the same time, you will also have to sharpen your skill. Because earlier what was used to happen is I used to know A, B, and C, and then there was someone who used to know X, Y, Z. So when these two people, they are working together, A, B, C plus X, Y, Z was sitting together. We are working in a very crazy environment. So now thing here is I know A, B, C and you know X, Y, Z. So how you are digitally going to engage? So skill set which was relevant 3 months back are probably 70% of the skill set probably might not be required. Okay, everything is required to be touched digitally, influenced digitally, and engaged digitally. So a couple of areas where I think people should now start scaling up themselves will be on a platform of a digital marketing. So knowledge of digital marketing is very, very important, because every organization will adapt digital marketing in one or the other way. So let it be in terms of customer acquisition, let it be in terms of customer engagement, let it be in terms of customer retention also. So I think if someone understands the skill set on working on a cloud platform, okay, take an example of a platform like Canva. So Canva is a fantastic platform wherein people can go work on a cloud environment and can be a good designer as well. Another skill set probably which will be required, because the moment we talk about digital marketing works on only on content. If you look up at Google, if you look up at Facebook, if you look up at YouTube, what are they hosting at the end of the day? They are just hosting a content. So content delivery will play a very critical role. Your website will have to be good content rich. Your blog will have to be great in terms of content. Your YouTube videos will have to be good with video content publishing and content creation. So I think if someone coming from that particular background, if you start scaling up yourself, so physical sales will not work. But yes, digital marketing work heavily, because ab role kya ho jayega? Your website, your social media, your Google ranking, your paid campaigns will have to do a job of a lead generation. So jo pehle mere yahan pe baith ke telemarketing, door to door marketing, sales coordinator kaam karta tha, now that all responsibility will have to be offloaded onto websites or their e-commerce portals. Okay, once website comes, yes, then there will be a team which is required to nurture the leads. Okay, so that cannot be replaced, because technology cannot nurture the lead. That I can talk to you, technology cannot speak to you, take down your requirements. So for that person is required. Meetings ke liye, then adopting a platform like Zoom or Skype or Google Hangout, those are going to play a very critical role. So if you ask me, in an area of a digital marketing, okay, particularly I'm talking about people who wants to make their career into marketing, sales or business development or marketing communication. For them, it will become very essential to be an expert onto digital marketing platform. Because every other person today has a website, but if your website doesn't get ranked up onto Google, then that website is nothing. Okay, it's just like a model of a car. It cannot transit anywhere. So we need now a mechanism wherein we make your model of a car, which is your website, to be the best sales engine or sales executive or sales manager of the organization. So learning digital marketing is very, very critical role, both at a level of execution, both at a level of adaptation. So at the owner level, people will also have to understand how they can use digital marketing to make their businesses relevant. Talking about parents, now parents should ensure that their kids develop a soft skill. Communication skill, writing skill, okay, and the production skill. So I think today, what we are doing right now, take an example, you are recording this webinar. Otherwise, it would have been a physical motivational session coming down at the college. So that would happen only once. Okay, I could come down and I could address to 50, 60, 100 students at that point. But today, once you are recording this video of this, now this is going to be a permanent inventory going and sitting up on your YouTube. I can look up at it, you can look up at it, the student can look up it at any given point of time. So what's happening is all your physical inventories are required to be published and protected into digital inventories. So parents will have to ask, insist their kids to become more practical now.
Great. I think, yeah, what you shared is really important. Moving ahead, could you tell us what kind of mobile apps do you develop, and what kind of skills a visual design student should possess to come into this sector?
Perfectly. All right. So I think very good question. Okay. So moment we talk about digital marketing, okay, we talk about digital selling or social selling. Important element here comes is a user interface and the user experience. Okay. Earlier it was being said when you go for a sales meeting, you should be properly decked up. You should be in a proper formal attire. Your communication has to be good. So what is that? It's user experience, because user on that side is experiencing you physically. Similar thing comes out here is when your customer, okay, is coming onto your website has to be engaging. It should give a right information with the right content, with the right intensity to different sets of the people. Because who are these people who are coming down to your websites? Are customers, competitors, potential partners, probably potential employers, employees. Okay, so every piece of the person coming on your website doesn't require to consume the full data. Okay, they are looking out for specific information. The moment you talk about specific, the user interface and user experiences are going to play very critical role. Okay, when it comes on to a design element, so the design thinking, okay, will now have to challenge all conventional thinking which was there, because all your critical problem will now be required to solve through a design thinking. Okay, so that is pertaining to this. Secondly, talking about mobile apps, I think a great shift, a great demand in a mobile apps is happening right now, because today people don't want to stick only to a laptop or a desktop or one particular table chair kind of an environment. They are on a movement. So when they are on a movement, there's only one piece of a technology which they carry with them. That's a mobile phone of yours. So your sales automation, your delivery automation, your customer engagement, everything will now have to start moving on to the mobile applications or mobile phone, because that's the only permanent thing which you carry for 18 hours a day with you. And that's something which you check out every 5 minutes or 10 minutes consistently. Okay. So now at this point of time, when you talk about a mobile application, a great scope for logistics mobile application is going to develop a lot. A lot of hypermarket local mobile application market is going to develop, with different people working from different areas. Okay, so your operations or your knowledge base transfer also is required to be transferred into mobile apps. So there is a great amount of requirement which is being generated for knowledge, great amount of for customer acquisition, sales automation or operation automation or project automation. So quite a lot of such thing is happening. So take an example. During this course of time, WhatsApp has been adopted very professionally, because you are connecting with your employees on a WhatsApp group, you are connecting with your customers on the WhatsApp group, you are escalating your challenges on a WhatsApp group. So WhatsApp is doing by and large pretty good, but there are challenges with WhatsApp, because you cannot track, you cannot understand kis din kaun sa ticket open hua tha and what's the status. It's a good information portal, it's a good information thing. So now what customers are doing with us is basically all their touch points are now being getting catered or now being getting transferred onto their mobile application requirement. So groceries are using mobile. So take an example like Chitle Bandhu is also going to come down with a mobile application, so that customer doesn't need to walk into their sweet shop and buy. They can just download that, they can just on a click of it, they can order, and with a platform like Dunzo, which is for local deliveries. So delivery can also happen in 2 to 3 hours of the time. So what Flipkart and Amazon did in past, now that is what would be moving forward with a Dunzo and with a individual organization having their own mobile apps and then their own e-commerce websites.
At a local level.
Because I see a great shift of adaptation. Because there's something which I need to buy right now. Okay, so for me the convenience was like I could move out of my home or my office. I can go down 15 minutes and I can get back with my material which I wanted. So, but I cannot transfer the same thing onto Flipkart. Flipkart will take sweet 2-3 days for me to deliver. So now what's going to happen here or happen or is going to, is happening at this point of time is essentially single store or multi-channel store or organized malls are now adapting their own local market app and local market e-commerce website. When they know that my customers are local, I will deliver to them local, but the delivery shouldn't exceed more than 2-3 hours of the time. So Dunzo as a platform comes very critically over there. So we work with matrimony portal. Okay, so we work with one of the largest matrimony portal with around 55,000 or 60-70,000 registered user with them. So earlier they were totally relying only onto the their matrimony portal, but now they started understanding that I cannot keep engaging my customer only through one particular platform. It will require an omni-channel presence. Okay, so they should be available on social media, they should be available on Google searches, they should be available on website, they should also be available on mobile app, because if once someone registers, it's so convenient, right? So we check our mobile app so frequently. So in fact, today 80% of the emails are opened up on mobile compared to desktop, which was earlier.
This is interesting. 80% of emails are now opened on mobile. This is post.
Yeah.
Okay. So now moving to your company, what kind of skill sets does your company demand in the candidates coming to you for jobs?
So we have two different categories in the businesses. Okay. One is digital marketing and second is the web and application development. So I'll speak first about digital marketing. For digital marketing skill set like content marketing, so bloggers or content writers are in a huge demand right now. Video production is in a huge demand. Graphic designers are in a huge demand right now. Second thing is social analytics, okay, or analytical skills are very, very important right now. Search engine optimization skill is very important. Social media platforms, so social media executive, social media handle, or social media strategist. These are a couple of skill sets, or probably when you have to run a Google AdWords. So, okay. So AdWords analyst or AdWords specialist is in a huge demand on one particular side. This is pertaining to the marketing side of the businesses. On the other side, we require a lot of Java developer, WordPress developer. We require a lot of UI UX developers or testers over there, .NET developers and Angular JS developers. So that happens to be on my other side of the business. So we require people who come down with a skill set that they want to do a career. An education institute can train up to one extent, but I think hands-on experience is very, very important for them to start working on it. So today, if education institute is teaching you something, okay, but that's not enough. Okay, so you need to have a practical experience, start building up your website, start building up your own blog pages, start building up your own social media pages. So I think at this point of time, there is a lot of DIY work which is required to be done, which is do it yourself. Education institutes are going to teach you, but you still need to be updated what is happening up latest on this particular technology platform. Okay, because these technology platforms are changing so fast, okay, your syllabus cannot accommodate that, because once the syllabus has been fixed and then there are certain obligations, then there are certain compliances pertaining to and universities which are required to be done, which you as an education institute are doing a great job. But when it comes on to market demand, there's altogether different sets of the things which is required. So students will have to understand what is latest. And I always believe one thing, rather than becoming master, jack of all and master of none, it's important to be a master of one. Okay, whatever it is. So there is a huge demand for WordPress developer. There is a huge demand for OpenCart e-commerce developer. There is a huge demand for search engine optimizer. There is a huge demand for content writer, videographer, video production, and all everything. So as long as you have that creative niche, creative edge in you, I'll tell you, you don't have to worry. There is a huge, huge, huge demand which is happening.
Great. So just curious, do you also hire freshers? If yes, what kind of positions are available for freshers in your company?
I think we are a fresher delight organization. Okay. We love freshers and freshers also love to work with us. There are two reasons. Okay. One is that we believe the kind of ओपन माइंडेडनेस विच इज फ्रेशर्स हैव इज नॉट प्रोबेबली अवेलेबल मोस्ट ऑफ द टाइम व्हेन यू हायर समवन कमिंग फ्रॉम अ डिफरेंट ऑर्गेनाइजेशन. Okay, and at the same time, freshers loves to work with us because they see the difference between academic qualification or a knowledge which they are acquiring and compared to a real-time industry output. We as organizations are known for a great organization culture. We are always fun at work. We have different kind of an activities happening up. And I believe one thing that I was a fresher when I joined this particular organization. So I am an employee and entrepreneur in the organization. So I believe every person potentially have that niche of an entrepreneurship provided right kind of a platform and opportunities are being provided. So keeping that in view, we have a policy of intern quota in the organization, wherein we have around 20-30% of our team strength work as a freshers. So while I go and speak at a lot of different forums, so we do open our doors to freshers because I think when freshers comes in, okay, they get in a liveliness in the organization. They come with a curiosity. They come with a zeal of learning on something. Though they are many instances, they are not very serious. For them, it's just like another certification. For them, it's like more look like more of a compliances which they need to submit it to institute. But when they come and start working with us, what they see a great culture. They also like to come and work. They also like to participate in the programs. The client kind of clientele what we work upon is we work with a larger size organization. We work with Tata, Kirloskar, Mahindra. We work with RBI. We work with Defense Ministry. We work with a couple of fashion brands. So they get a good amount of exposure. And as I said earlier also that we are 360 degree company. And there's a very rare combination where company does social media and does a website, does a e-commerce and also does a development. Has a team for development infrastructure and also has got a creative way. So we are a creative and a technology company both put together. So we are communication as well as a web application development company as well. So yes, we do recruit, we do love to have a lot of fresher onboarded with us. Generally, another benefit what we have with freshers is we can mold them. Okay, they come with an intent of learning. Okay, and once we mold them, we have 3 months and the 6 months of the internship program. 3 months is generally internship, and if we like these freshers, and if we see that they are able to adapt our system, processes, and the culture of the organization, we put them into probation. And most of the time, we hire them as well if a candidate is serious enough, and if the person has got that kind of zeal. So as an educational institute, okay, you should look up at it that you should try to put up your student at some kind of an internship program. You can identify. So don't give internship to students to any organization which opens the door. Do a proper audit because there are high chances of reducing your effort in terms of the placement eventually. If a right candidate is sent to a right organization, the placement happens up automatically. Second thing is why we love freshers is because during this 3 months of the internship program, we expose them to our best class system and processes what we work upon, based on the technology, based on the marketing campaign, based on the processes what we use upon, because our processes are also being industry benchmark. Okay, so another benefit for us is we get freshers at cheaper cost as a company when I run. So every organization today will have a constraint of cost control. So I think it's going to be a great opportunity for freshers to get enrolled into organization. So first target should be to get enrolled into organization. Once they are able to enroll, please see to it that you adapt to the culture of the organization, processes of the organization, so that your job hunting, finding another company, effort get reduced down over there. So we are a fresher delight company. We love freshers. We would like to have freshers. Freshers bring in lot of energy. They bring in lot of enthusiasm. They bring in lot of charm in the organization. And we also feel that we are also contributing back to something. Because freshers have a sense of gratitude as well. Yes, ye company hai jahan pe hum log gaye, humko ye banaya, humko ye karwa ke liya. And generally what we see is that the retainership of a fresher is higher, because if you get a fresher, if you nurture a fresher and if you onboard a fresher, their chances of remaining with the company is longer compared to when you hire a talent from outside.
Exactly. Yeah. So what are your future plans?
So future plans when you speak about, okay, so I believe one thing, okay, what was relevant yesterday is no relevant today. what is relevant today is not going to be relevant tomorrow. But one thing is very, very certain that I feel very privileged to the about one thing, that the kind of industry which I am in. This is a booming industry. This industry is still not seen the real exploration of this, of the height where it could be going. And today, every world is eyeing towards the digital initiatives. Let it be marketing, let it be technologies, and I think we are at a right time in a right kind of an industry. Okay, and I think we just want to be relevant. Whatever we are doing, we want to see to it that whatever we are doing is relevant, adds a value to the customer. And I think customer is like an ocean. He will itself make the, ensure that my boat sails through. Okay, naya apni customer paar laga dega. Sirf hum log unki naya paar lagate hain is waqt mein. And we just want to upscale and do forward and backward integration. That's what is one of the things which we are looking out for. So there are a couple of sets of the services which we offer to our customer. So we are also on a mode of couple of more partnership to with organization who adds up another layers to whatever we are offering to our customer. So lots of digital marketing and technology thing which are being adopted. So, and customers are very open with a real time new ideas, new innovation which they wanted to do. So I think we see a great future in this, and people who are looking out from a career perspective should look out for this industry certainly.
Definitely. Now coming to the last question for today, how should students make their showreel if they want to come in your field that you are serving in? And what are the typical mistakes that you must have seen in the various showreels that you have gone through?
So I will try to put it up into different format. Okay. Jo dikhta hai, wo bikta hai. Okay. How you present is how you will be perceived. So I will try to put it up into format. Is one is make your own creative resume. Okay, we are talking here purely in perspective of a candidate looking forward to work with the organization. So gone are those days where the paper-based resumes are going to work. You have paper liya, uspe apna resume bana diya, and you're forwarding to HR of the organization. That's fairly okay. It's koi dikkat wali baat nahi. But best part would be if you can do a video test, a video resume of yours. When you go back, because at the end of the day, we as an employer, what do we look up at is we look up at a body language, we look up at communication, we look up at the content of the thing. Okay, now resume at any given point of time can never stick, because I don't remember 10% of the resumes also I generally look up at it. Once some candidate comes and sits in front of me, there is always a face-to-face body language communication which happens support there. Now, if the same thing, it can also be replaced to a digital technology. Okay, you make a good resume of yours on a YouTube, okay, and upload it over there. So along with your resume, you can just put up a QR code. So you need to have that creative edge of getting through with everything. Okay, so when you send a resume, say that look out for my video resume. So what happens is now 99% of the people don't adopt that. But when you are that 1%, your chances of getting into organization become much brighter. That is one thing. Second thing is going to an organization, please be prepared. I see most of the company come just blank. They need to understand that when they are coming and spending 30 minutes to travel and another 20-30 minutes to interview and another 1 or 2 hours to look up at it. If you don't do a right background study about organization, what happens is you become a commodity. So if I am at a new candidate place, when I go and meet up any of my new client or prospect, okay, so I'm also trying to recruit myself there. So what I do is I study there who is a managing director, who is a HR, or who is this and who is that kind of thing. LinkedIn is a great platform to be there. And when you go to an organization and they open up the interview, if you tell them, no, wow, I have been to your website and it's amazing. I read your blog on so and so kind of thing. Okay. And so what happens is you already had one half of the battle, because you already convinced them that you know about their organization, you have, and you have a right intent of working with them. And what we look out for is the intent of the people. Skill is something which can be developed, but intent is something which cannot be developed. So intent is something what we generally look out for when we hire any person, because there are loads of people with skill, but problem is with the attitude and with the intent of the people. So if you are able to showcase your intent and attitude in the right format at the right time, because interview is your right time, okay, either you are going to make it or it's going to be break it for you. So when you go, once you go there, also make a proper script how you are going to present yourself. So making a proper, so I see to it that lots of people come with a blind mind. Okay, they'll come and then they'll say, can I have an access to my Gmail? So they will need an access to Gmail and then they'll try to show it. So if something of that sort can be made available, or probably if a PPT of theirs is being made available, rather than showing a hard paper is good. Okay, but today every person has got their own laptop or iPad or mobile phone. So if they try to convince someone with a different level of the approach, and if they try to present saying that, sir, let me present it to you. So the interview itself happens to the presentation. And then the candidate drives how the interview is to be conducted, rather than an HR or the organization head who's driving, please answer me. So when you have PPT, then you are explaining what you want to explain, and then someone is open for the question and answer. So it should be like a sales speech.
Exactly. I think the two things that you mentioned are really very interesting. One is about having a video resume, and the other one is about having a good intent. So I think this was a very helpful discussion, and I'm sure our students are really going to pick up very good things from this interview. Thank you so much, Ashish, for sparing us the time and efforts.
Thanks a lot, Vushal, for having me over here. It's always an opportunity to be connected with an esteemed organization like yours, Veda. Okay, I have been to your organization. I have seen a great amount of talent which lies in your students. Okay, now what is only required is that now they require to be thrown up into an industry where there is a huge demand. And I think you will have to play a good and a catalyst role over there to connect the dots. If you are able to connect the dots, then there is a bigger line which gets established over there.